happy face, hair.
Melissa and Mark Jones say they live among angels.
They're gonna hug you, they're gonna wanna kiss you, they're gonna wanna show you stuff, they're just full of love.
Their unusual happiness, one of the signature symptoms of Angelman syndrome, a rare and complex genetic disorder that also causes developmental delays, seizures, and sleeping problems. But when they're anxious, they act out.
Just having one child with a syndrome like this is difficult, and to have four.
Dr. Ron Thiebert runs the Angelman syndrome program at Mass General Hospital. He's seen nearly 300 cases, more than anyone else, but he's never seen four siblings from the same family. They drove 9 hours from their home in Ohio for this appointment.
And just the fact that they could come out to Boston is amazing.
Melissa says she gets that reaction a lot. Her two oldest children do not have Angelman's, but through a very rare quirk of genetics involving chromosome 15, the four youngest do.
It's different when they're adults trying to get them to behave than when they're little.
Melissa says she knew when her children were toddlers they had developmental delays. They weren't talking or sleeping normally, and she worried most about their seizures. But for a long time, there was no diagnosis.
I went through a lot of stuff trying to figure out what was wrong. And what people do not understand is that genetics is so much more refined now than it was back in that time frame.
Without genetic testing, many children with Angelman's were misdiagnosed with autism or cerebral palsy. So Dr. Thiebert says he's still collecting data on what happens to angels as they age.
We do see some things get better, such as seizures and sometimes sleep, but what we see get worse is anxiety.
Melissa says she's leaving MGH with new advice about nutrition and medication. It should help improve their quality of life and hers.
They're super precious. They really are like angels.
So even though these four children have the same genetic condition from the same parent, the severity of some of their symptoms is different. And Dr. Thiebert hopes that those differences could provide more clues about Angelman and other genetic disorders.